it was the banjo first for me when I first got exposed to old time music. It was, there was something about it, just the plunkiness of it. The only banjo I'd been exposed to was bluegrass banjo, and it's so, I was just fascinated with the difference of clawhammer banjo, you know, old time banjo, and it was the banjo first, and then the fiddle.
Do you sense that there are people who are going to continue with it, or that it maybe is just...
It seems to be there's an overall change in the wind in terms of what is a value, you know, in our culture. It seems like that's starting to change, the idea of homemade music, the idea of music that's historically has a connection to... you know, our history. I mean, it doesn't exist in a vacuum. It's not something we got from somewhere else. It's our history, not just Black people, not just white people, not just natives, but everybody, you know, and it's what I'm hoping is that when people tap into it, it's like, I'm just going to play, you know, old time for a while and move on to something else. No, it's like, I'm going to play old time and then see what happens after that. You know, rather than using it as a stepping stone to somewhere else, where can we take old time? If we're living in it, then we're changing it, you know, rather than just sort of using what some fiddler 50 years ago, how he played it and playing it exactly like that for the next 40 years. Yeah, people are going to move on. But if we can take it and then live in it and see what happens, I mean, I'm hoping that that is what happens this time, you know, and that we can all be playing homemade music for a long time.